78th edition of the Mondial de l'Automobile, the Paris Motor Show, took place in the Parc des Expositions de la Porte de Versailles in Paris. Many car manufacturers rose to the occasion to showcase their world premieres and their future dreams. At Seat, the second generation Toledo was the star of the show. A smooth, rounded silhouette with a single kidney nose and an Audi dashboard, all that to a Seat price made it an offer rather hard to refuse. Ford showed the long-expected successor of the Escort. The Focus had an outstanding design with its new edge lines and would eventually become the world's best-sold car. Merge the words velocity and satisfaction and you'll get Velsatis. Well, that's French humor for you. The Renault Velsatis started life as a futuristic concept car, but many aspects would see real life, like in the Velsatis production car, the Avantime and the second generation Mégane. In 1998, the Lamborghini Diablo was not far from being discontinued, but it still was sexy enough to shine on the show. Giorgetto Giugiaro designed the stunning Bugatti EB118, a concept car with an 18-cylinder engine under the hood, producing 555 horsepower. It was inspired from the 57 SC Atlantic. For the youngsters who don't remember where Bugatti came from, they parked a 1930 Type 41 Royale next to it. At Citroën, the Xara Picasso drew all the attention to itself. Sure, the design was extrovert, but I doubted that good old Pablo would have agreed with his signature on the fenders. Nevertheless, the Picasso would become a huge success. That never happened to the Lumiere, simply because it was a show car. Based on the Deux Chevaux though, and it eventually led to the Citroën C3. The Ferrari 456 was a bit outdated back in 1998, so it received what Italians call a modificata. And that's what the M stands for on the overhauled Ferrari 456M. Buried in time and totally forgotten. I still got this picture though. If you know of any Daewoo Joystar fan club somewhere in the world, please let me know. Another vanished brand, but unlike Daewoo, dearly remembered. Lancia, still alive and kicking back then, showed its stunning Dialogos concept car. More realistic was this Alfa Romeo 166, successor to the 164. It never really was successful, but to Alfa lovers, the 166 is iconic for eternity. A Volkswagen Golf sedan? It's purely coincidental that Bora sounds a bit like boring. And yes, I took this picture, but today I have no clue what I was taking a picture of back then. If you do, please let me know in the comments.